harness the full potential of the spacecraft platform by using our design tools. This video will cover the basics of our design tool so that you can get started on crafting your website. Start from your dashboard main page, then select Design in the top navigation bar. From here, you will see our design preview window on the left and the design panel on the right. Use the design window to test and preview your design settings. Use the design panel to adjust all of these settings. You will notice two tabs on the top right-hand side. Site-wide is where changes can be made to the entire site, and page is where design edits will only affect that specific page. Click into a section of your page in the design viewer, and it will immediately show up in the design panel. We will cover the site-wide tab now, and then follow up with the page level settings. Site-wide's name is self-explanatory. All of your site-wide design settings are chosen within this panel. You can see here, all areas of your site have been organized into individual setting panels. Let's have a look at each of these panels. After you opened your design tool, the site-wide tab was selected automatically. Open the layout panel, you will see the currently selected layout. This layout option specifically allows you to stretch the header and navigation to window edges. All of your other layout options are also found here. Just open the drop-down and try out a different one. You also have the option to add or remove padding at the top of the site using the slider in this area. Let's back out of this panel and look at the styles area. Then select controls. Here you will see styling options for different clickable elements on your site. Your button's background color, the corner style, or font size is easily changed right here. Look below, and you can change your default link colors in this area. If you use image gallery slideshows on your site, we have over 40 different gallery arrow variations, allowing you to match every part of your site to your brand with these options. Going back to styles, select text. You have many font options for each header and content area of your site. Align your text, change the colors, adjust size. Expand the content dropdown. Here are the default styling options for your main site content. Back to styles, now select images. Here you can add drop shadows or borders to all of your images. Go back again and select content blocks. The option to stretch block background colors or images to the window's edge is here. You can add a default amount of padding to every block you add to your site. Then you can add or remove bottom margin or even include a border on all of your blocks. Click back to styles and now select collections. Your collection design settings are found right here. Select the events panel. Choose the default settings for all of your event feeds in this area. Always check back on our site for new cool data sources that you can add to your site. Going back to styles, now select wrapper. Enable a content wrapper here, then add or remove a custom background. By enabling a wrapper on your site, it centers the main body of the site to the center of your browser. This in turn grants you the option to place a background color or image in the wrapper that sits right behind your body content. Now let's navigate back to the main site-wide panel. Select header and logo. We've made it really easy to upload graphics and photos to your site. To replace your logo, simply click, hold, and drag your logo from your computer's desktop into the SpaceCraft tools. There are many options to style the header and logo. Set the max width for your logo on mobile, or maybe add a bit of padding around it. Back to site-wide, select navigation. You will notice two tabs, one for desktop and one for mobile. Six different navigation styles are available to you. Adjust the font and text styling selections right here. Upload a custom image background in the container area. Adding a custom image to the background of your navigation menu will appear behind your navigation links only within the navigation area of your site. Select the mobile tab and you can choose how your navigation looks and works on mobile. Back out of here and look at the sidebar area. There appears to be no content in this site's sidebar, so customization isn't available here. If there were blocks placed into your sidebar, you would see each block title listed in this area. The sidebar is similar to the footer. It will be visible on all of your pages unless you turn it off for any specific page. Back again, now select footer. Add more columns to the footer's content. Adjust text size or text color, or enable the social icon links to open in a new window. Back to site-wide, now jump into the background settings area. Here you have a lot of styling options for your site-wide background. Select the pattern button to add a pattern background to your site. Select the custom button to upload or choose a background image that you have chosen. Use the blue area to select and upload your image, or drag and drop directly from your desktop. You will see options for color overlay, its opacity, image position, and how the image sits as the page scrolls. Check out the option Resize Background Image Based on Device Type, and it will allow your images to responsibly size for all devices. Now let's move to the Page tab. From here, you'll be able to make all page level design changes. This page already has a button placed into it. This button is created so customers can easily click to the reservations page. We want to make it look like a hero image, so let's add a fully stretched background image to it. Select the button from the list of blocks on the right. Find the container area at the bottom, and then select the custom button. Use the upload field to upload a new one, or choose an image already uploaded to your library. Look down for the padding area. Input a good pixel amount in the top and bottom portion of the container. If you feel the need to change your button's title, you can click into the button from the design tool and edit it. Now we want to show you how image galleries are set up, so back out of this panel by clicking the arrow icon. Select your image gallery from the list of blocks. You can see that this image gallery is set as a mosaic currently. You can easily change that by clicking into the type area, then you will see your different gallery layout options. I'm selecting slideshow right here. You can turn it into an automatic slideshow by changing these interval options. You can make the slideshow gallery slide each image from the side of the screen, allow the images to fade in, select one or multiple photos to appear at once, or choose the speed at which the images transition with the delay slider. Maybe you'd like the carousel option more. You can choose it as well. A border might look good around these images. In the images area, you can see a checkbox to enable borders on the images. Use the slider to add a thicker border, or use the color picker to adjust its color. Now let's move to another page with a simple list. A simple list allows you to organize items with titles, images, descriptions, and links for each item, all within one single block. You will see as I hover over each of these images, there is a colorized effect. After clicking into the block settings, you will see you can change or add hover effects in the images area. Starting on the hover tab firstly for effects, you will see a drop-down box with 10 options. Choose one you might like, but colorize is chosen here. Then add a hover color, adjust the opacity, or include an image title or description on the images. When you want to save your settings in this panel, hit the save button on the bottom. When this is done, then select publish to make it live to your site. Otherwise, you can preview your site immediately in a new tab by selecting this icon here. You also have options to preview your site in other devices: desktop, tablet, immobile views within the design tool. If you wish to save your design for later use, you can use these tools here: backup the current design, view current backups, and reset to your most recent published version with these three buttons. And there you have it, a complete rundown of the SpaceCraft Design tool. If you have any more questions after watching this video, please feel free to reach out to support@gospacecraft.com. If you are one of our concierge members, give us a call at 888-534-2183. Thanks for watching.